A connection between COVID and pollution.
Oh, good. Well, something light, Giuliana. Qualcosa di leggero, di dimagrante.
Bello. From fondazioneveronesi.it read an article.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
I have to read.
Yes, please. Mm-hmm.
In Italy, the areas most affected by COVID-19 were those characterized by a greater presence of fine dust in the air. Hence, the hypothesis that the spread of the virus and its aggressiveness may have been affected by air pollution. The assumption that smog and the higher concentration of fine particles may have increased the risk of contagion and favored a faster course of the disease stems from the acknowledgement that air pollution is associated with an increased risk of prolonged inflammation, even in young and healthy subjects, with the consequent hyperactivation of the immune system, explained Andrea Ranzi, environmental epidemiologist of the Regional Agency for Environmental Protection of Emilia-Romagna. Characteristics, moreover, common to those found in patients affected by COVID-19. Hence, the hypothesis that living in a place with an unhealthy air may have made the impact of the disease more evident. To this, it should be added that those who habitually breathe air loaded with atmospheric pollutants are at greater risk of contracting respiratory infections, and that some similar evidence, correlation between pollution and infection, had already emerged at the beginning of a century on the occasion of the advent of SARS. The high level of fine particles present in the Po Valley could have paved the way for the spread of SARS-CoV-2 and contributed to determining that between Piedmont, Lombardy, Veneto, and Emilia-Romagna there were almost 80 per 100 of deaths. No, according to the opinion of Pier Mannuccio Mannucci, emeritus professor of internal medicine at the State University of Milan and member of the scientific committee of Umberto Veronesi Foundation. The fact that the epidemic has hit the Po Valley with greater force may be due to several reasons. First of all, being one of the most industrialized areas in the country, with a large number of international contacts. This aspect, together with a high population density, can be considered the major determinant of the surge in infection in recent months. Sergio Arari, director of the pneumology unit of the San Giuseppe Hospital in Milan, ruled out the possibility that the virus could travel on board the fine particles. The virus is mostly transmitted via the respiratory droplets of an infected person who coughs, sneezes, or talks at close range. Contagion from infected surfaces is rarer, while some indication suggests that the virus may remain infectious in the aerosol of a closed environment. The available research is therefore unable to demonstrate a cause and effect relationship between smog and infections. According to experts, the drastic decline in infections following the lockdown and the social distancing also suggests that particulate matter is not decisive in the transmission of the virus. Having said that, a relationship between pollution and the pandemic cannot be excluded, specifically in relation to the possible worsening of the course of the disease once overcontamination has occurred. In fact, it is known that environmental pollution increases the likelihood of cardiovascular, metabolic and lung disease, cioè peggiora queste malattie già nella persona. Quindi se uno prende il COVID ed è predisposto per debolezza polmonare, cardiovascolare, eccetera, naturalmente la persona ha delle reazioni che sono peggiori di quelle in una persona che prende la malattia ma non ha una predisposizione, una immunodeficienza, insomma, più evidente. Polluting particulate matter leads to an increase in the inflammatory response in the lungs. This aspect, in the presence of SARS-CoV-2, can favor the appearance of more serious symptoms. By analogy with what is observed for other disease, it is possible that higher level of environmental pollution have made infected people more susceptible to the progression of COVID-19, said Francesco Forastiere, environmental epidemiologist at CNR and the King's College London. To final data, rigorous epidemiological studies will be necessary with an adequate collection of clinical and environmental data on an individual basis as homogeneous as possible through the national territory. In my opinion, there is a connection with air pollution and COVID and the diffusion of this kind of illness. But I am agree that there are a lot of people who have this illness and are predisposti, che non so come si dica in questo momento, predisposti a un peggioramento, diciamo, di questa malattia.
Mm-hmm. And did you know, by the way, that now we've got even the New Yorker edition, the New Yorker variant. And so every day we've got just another variant.
It's terrible.
It's terrible. The never-ending story. Never-ending
story, yes.
Okay, thank you. You did a great job. So you said you found where all this.
Dunque, fondazioneveronesi.it magazine, articoli, cardiologia, inquinamento.
Mm-hmm. And you are directly involved, because are you working or are you studying something about this?
No, I have only read articles.
So you've got a passion for COVID.
No, I'm just joking. È l'argomento del giorno, che chi si vuol parlare ormai.
Ah, yes, of course. Okay, good. Thank you, Giuliana. So, someone else? Lucia, Doris, Walter, Aurelia, Antonio, Grazianella, Roberta, Santina, Virginia.
Antonio.
Pronto?
Pronto?
Chi c'è per primo?
Parlo? Sì, sì. È su Walter, poi non lo so.
Allora, due cose. Una, volevo dirvi a proposito dell'Iracius, del famoso fiore, eccetera. Ho fatto, intanto ho cercato sul web qualche foto. Io mi ricordo di aver visto una specie di questo anni fa, non qui a Milano, in Toscana. E sono andato a cercarlo dove il biologo ha detto di averlo messo giù, però diciamo che alla cascina all'interno non c'è. Ho contattato direttamente il biologo, ci siamo scambiati due cose e dobbiamo rimandare un attimo, perché io poi vorrei, insieme a due righe di relazione, tirar fuori una fotografia che sia decente di questo benedetto fiore, per far capire.
Wonderful.
Com'è. Però dobbiamo rimandarla, perché fiorisce decentemente alla fine di aprile.
Ah, fantastico, molto okay. Bene.
Da aprile in avanti, attualmente so dov'è, chiaramente non pubblicherò, cioè non dirò dove è, perché mi hanno vietato di dirlo.
Ah, ok. Esatto.
E poi vabbè, pubblicherò questa foto e metterò giù quello che ho trovato sulla ricerca che ho tirato fuori.
Scusa, ma a Lambrate però... c'è ancora anche lì in zona Lambrate, che ho detto che l'hanno scoperto lì, risulta?
Guardate un po' qua, questa è la fotografia del ieraccio, quello lì giallo è il ieraccio,
sì,
milanese.
È una specie, diciamo così, che
è una specie qua.
Assomiglia al tarassaco, ma assomiglia soltanto perché è giallo e perché ha delle foglie, delle, diciamo dei petalini che assomigliano a quelli, ma il tarassaco ha i petali molto compatti, mentre questi sono i petali, sono diciamo delle striscioline, è più piccolo intanto come corona, sono striscioline separate, tutte insieme come quello. E poi il tarassaco è basso come fusto, mentre invece questo ha un fusto che sale molto, e sul fusto si dirama e sulla diramazione ci sono due o tre di questi fiorini. Saltato questo, invece I read my glass half empty, my personal
half entry, my half empty glass, il mio bicchiere è mezzo vuoto, ok,
esatto. My personal free thoughts on our green energy. Clean energy or green energy. Green is fine, but we have a lot of false greens. We had built two nuclear power plants to produce energy, electricity, but many green people voted to shut them off. But now we buy electric energy by France, nuclear center, and other countries. This is no sense. In our bills, we pay a fee for nuclear deposit, and the cost of electricity is more expensive than in other countries. The Greens that don't want trees that have fallen in streams to be taken, but these trees can then form diques between the brick pillars. It causes the water level to rise temporarily and create flooding. The Greens don't want diggings to lower the riverbed, but prefer to raise the bank. Diggings the riverbed produced free building material. To raise the banks, we have to buy the material. The Aulla è un paese della Toscana.
In Toscana.
Mm-hmm. The Aulla disaster should have taught us just that, but instead they have unnecessarily raised the banks and the trunks of the trees being in the river bed. We are stupid, or there are green stupid. There are many politicians who talk about green energy and reducing dependence on oil, favoring or purchasing the electrical car. Yes, well, but there are no charging stations. There are few and badly positioned in the city and in the suburbs.
Yeah.
They took about monoelectric skates, but didn't set the rules for their circulation and parking, and and there is no insurance obligation. Politicians have offered has opportunity to save energy by cooking our homes for free and putting solar panel in on the roofs. But the method imposed is so complicated that it is not applicable. Too many us and politicians lack a mental organization of the future for everything. That's why I say they only know to talk. They talk. We should have more confidence in green energy. It is our future. It's gone.
It's all? Okay. Good. It is a very, very good work you did.
È un mio pensiero libero.
Ah, okay. Your free thought. Fine. Thank you, Walter. Very well. Bene. Poi c'era Antonio e poi c'era anche Fabrizio Pompinuccia.
E anche Grazianella dopo.
E anche Grazianella. Perfetto. Andiamo. Coraggio.
Allora, Antonio. Io avevo fatto qualcosa che mi aveva indicato lei sulla coltivazione del tè e lo sfruttamento delle popolazioni indiane nelle piantagioni.
Sì, molto bene. Very well.
Today, 4/5 of world tea production, altogether close to 6 million tons, is made in China, India, Sri Lanka, Kenya and Turkey. The first three producing countries consume large quantities, with China absorbing about 1.5 million tons in a growth trend. Compared to the Western style, its consumption, however, in the country of the oldest tradition, tea retains a social and ritual aspect. In the United Kingdom, consumption is around 2.2 kilograms per year per capita, down compared in the imperial area. The cultivation of tea. The spread of tea is due to the British, who in the 1830s exported the cultivation, until then extensively practiced only in China and Japan, to India and to the island of Ceylon, today's Sri Lanka. At the beginning of the following century, production expanded further and the system of large plantation is launched, which still dominate the market today, even if small producers, often grouped in consortia or cooperatives, are a significant reality. Labor market and marketing. Today, there is no single reference market prices. Market prices are set by auction sales organized in the countries of origin, and more than 3/4 of the world's tea production is marketed in this way. In essence, the system has changed little since the colonial era. The market is controlled by few multinationals. Production takes place in the aforementioned nations, generally poor or developing, while the processing of blends, market and distribution take place in Western countries. Furthermore, the involvement and intermediaries, retailers and suppliers contribute to raising tariffs to the detriment of workers and final consumers. To correct the distortions and injustice of this situation, Fair Trade seeks to ensure a fair and a stable price for small business, coordinating with the certification bodies of production, working and condition and organic farming. Working condition and exploitation. The main problem of tea cultivation are linked to the condition of the workers, mostly female workers, especially in the lace plantation managed by multinational companies. This crop, in addition to requiring of a lot of manpower, in fact, involves a considerable physical effort, protracted for many hours, and in producing countries, moreover. The protection for personnel is not comparable to the European ones. In India, the second largest producer in the world, about 3.5 million people are employed in the cultivation of tea in condition of severe exploitation. This work is handed down from generation to generation and is entrusted to Dalit women, to outcast group known as the untouchables. The poorest and most oppressed in the Indian society hierarchy. Mm-hmm. The income amounts to just over $2 a day for 12 hours of work, and their harvesters live isolated in agglomeration of shacks without sanitation inside the plantations, completely depend on companies which manage food, housing, education, and health. These power equality services are lost immediately in the event of the closure of companies or the cessation of family continuity of work. As if that weren't enough, trade unions are often corrupt and complicit in the system. To rebel against the situation, in 2015, the women of Kerala organized a major strike, bringing to light the terrible living condition in the plantation, supported by NGO Doors Jagron. Fortunately, not all producers impose this condition. In fact, small companies and consortia, even better if they are of a fair and solidarity type, as previously underlined, can be a guarantee of better life and work situation. It remains for consumers, therefore, to choose to prefer the tea produced by these realities.
Very well. Which are your sources, Antonio?
La Repubblica Salute. Mm.
21, La Repubblica Salute.
Mm-hmm. 21 October 2015.
Okay, good.
Mm-hmm. And there is another little article for this question.
Yes.
Very hard. Indian tea slaves less than $2 a day. Mm. Several local NGOs report that 2,000 workers have died of malnutrition in the last 15 years. India, the second largest tea producer in the world, employs 3.5 million people on plantation in slavery condition. Has been independent since 1947. Some sectors are slow to free themselves from the legacies of the colonial era. Unworthy legacies, such as the death of the tea production system, remain to the detriment of the poorest. Death in the plantation is a job that is handed down from generation to generation, and not only for the mastery of the elders, which the successors treasure, but also and above all for a sort of condemnation ad vitam aeternam. From 1800 to today, the slave system imposed by the British in the 19th century persist in West Bengal, one of the most important areas of tea production. Most of the people employed in this sector are women whose living conditions slavishly reflect those of their ancestor island slaves. Isolated in remote colonies among the fields, they depend from every point of view on the companies. They work for house, food, water, electricity, health, education. Everything is controlled and managed by companies. They have no property whatsoever and can only remain in their homes if another family member continues to work on the plantation. In the event that the companies go bankrupt, tea leaf pickers, 3.5 million across India, spread across 1.5 existing plantation, are left without wages, without water, and without food. According to the local NGO Duarte Jegron, in fact, 2,000 deaths from malnutrition in the last 15 years are reported. A few meters from the fields was Shannery is apparently idyllic, reside the workers. The accommodation have no toilet facilities. In one of the village of Mugulkata, for example, there is only one for 500 people, and women are forced to reach the open wells, real marshes. This is why they frequently get dysentery and are further penalized due to the halved daily wage. In this regard, it should be noted that the income amounts to less than $2 a day.
Terrible. So, I see. You did a lot of work. When we drink tea, we should think about it.
We should think this.
Yes, it's true. I thank you so much, Antonio. And I was just wondering, wouldn't you send it by mail to Evelina?
Yes, of course.
Ok, questo vale anche per tutti. Io vi invito comunque, ovviamente non li avrete tutti scritti a mano, no? Quelli che magari l'hanno già prodotto potrebbero mandarlo per mail a Evelina, così finalmente possiamo compattare un po' tutto il lavoro che è stato fatto finora. Ok? I thank you so much, Antonio. It's a great work. Thank you. Just go on like this. Continua pure così. It's a very nice way. Thank you. Bene. Okay. Poi, chi c'era? Grazianella, Fabrizio, Pinuccia, coraggio.
Grazianella.
Vai.
Ah, scusa, vuoi fare...
No, vai Grazianella, vai, vado dopo, tranquilla.
Allora, okay. I found the insert of Corriere della Sera that you told.
This one.
Yes, my husband, yes.
Okay.
Bought, but he did not give me. And after I asked, and he's in the car. In the after yesterday, I have.
Ah, okay.
And I saw there are many interesting things, and
yes.
I translated some two articles. One is about orto, in italiano, orto verticale.
Mm-hmm.
Quindi... quindi in Milan, in Cavenago e in Melzo. I don't know where it is because I don't know the place, but I know that is the periferia of Milano, no? Allora, in Cavenago e in Melzo, the vertical farming expands with salads and vegetables without pesticides.
Mm.
This is the first vertical made in Italy garden appeared during Expo 2015. Did you go to the Expo?
Yes, many yes. times, and you? Yes, I liked
Rotary.
It.
Also, I went for 6 months because I liked it a lot. Also, I was a voluntary for 2 weeks.
Ah, where? End, in which sector?
In different place. I don't remember the name, but it is... non mi ricordo in effetti, but it was the 2 last weeks.
Mm-hmm.
And we thought, no, a lot of people, no, it were a lot people who arrived. We spoke in English, we explained many things, I put the indication to see, because many people wanted to have a queue to go to Japan, to go, but if you go only one day, it's not good to go only in one to do similar queue. But yes. In effect, I saw this vertical, Ortono, but I did not have a very interesting because many no people explain the very important thing what is.
Mm-hmm.
In effect, now there is the reaction now in Milan. Allora, by architect Gabriella Femmina Funaro. Zero pesticides and the waste, but the products of the highest quality. Cioè basil, understand?
Yes.
Basilico and mm-hmm. Come si dice lattuce?
Lettuce.
Ecco, grown up in a farm high tech with the cups, cioè cubetti, in nutritional solutions. Planet Farms was created after a visit in Japan, where there is a farm where grown up 30,000 cesti, non mi viene, non so, cesti di lattuga, lattuse, every mm-hmm. day from 2007.
Mm-hmm.
Quindi loro l'hanno attuato in effetti 2 anni dopo l'Expo. Luca Travaglini is a founder of Planet Farms. Quindi the name in Milan, in Cavenago, is Planet Farms. With mm-hmm. Gabriele Benatoff. They realize 40,000 packs of mixed salad per day
mm-hmm.
in a few minutes without contamination, these products non require washing. Quindi you can buy these products, I think, in the supermarket, I don't know, I can see the future
mm-hmm.
and you don't know wash these products. Another farm, quindi questo è quello di Cavenago. This mm-hmm. is another farm, the name is Agricola Moderna, founded in 2018 mm-hmm. per Luigi Giuliani e Benjamin Franchetti in Milano. They had in the past a team of 18 people, 3 agronomists and 2 engineers. Now they work in Melzo near Milano in 1,015 square meters in which they cultivate vegetables, realizing a found packs a day. Buying che sono comprati by people who look for
boat by people
boat, ecco, io non so perché ho messo invece buying boat in generale, va bene. Boat by people who look for products and quality ed attentive to the environment.
Mm-hmm.
In particular many female than men, quindi many women than men.
Mm-hmm. More women than men, okay, yes. Mm-hmm.
Normally you go to spend the supermarket woman.
Yeah.
Planet Farms save until 98% of water. Quindi loro risparmiano 98% di acqua, without pesticides. Production does not depend on the weather and DOF, cioè siccità, e flows, quindi alluvioni, favoring programming. Vertical farming is an ally, quindi alleato, of science and technology.
Ok, very well.
Questo è uno, poi faccio parlare gli altri, poi dopo casomai ce n'è un altro.
Ah, ok.
Ne ho fatti ieri sera, di sera li faccio io.
Ok, thank you, Grazianella. Ok, let's listen. Yes, ok, good. Let's listen to Fabrizio Pinuccia and then you go on with your one, ok? Grazianella?
Yes, okay. Yes.
Mm-hmm. Sì, io ho fatto la traduzione, no, ho fatto il riassunto del fiore che sboccia solo a Milano. Ok?
Yes.
There is a flower who lives only in Milan. Your name is Ieraccio Milanese.
Il suo nome del fiore, its name is Ieraccio Milanese.
Ieraccio Milanese è its located on the walls of Sforza Castle. It's a wild salad with yellow flowers and blooms between June and September. It was identified on the walls of the castle by Fenaroli in 1926. Its trace were lost until 2011 when it's founded by Gabriele Galasso. Natural Historic Museum Botanical in only four specimens. In Milan there are space for biodiversity, there are space for of plants that were believed to be extincted, but in place untreated sauvage, like the train tracks or in periphery.
In the suburbs, okay.
Like the Parco delle Cave o Cascina all'interno. Where messy bio it's often synonymous with biodiversity.
Good. Molto bene. Thank you. Okay. Thank you, Pinuccia. And what about you, Fabrizio? Did you write anything?
No, anything, because...
Are you feeling well?
Yesterday I spent all day with my grandson, and today I have... two wings on my shoulder. next time.
Like an angel.
I can continue my job.
Okay, maybe for the next week, for Monday, maybe. If you want, if you just want.
Gli uomini si esauriscono presto.
Yes, they exhaust.
Suddenly they
are exhausted. I don't understand it, but it is like this.
Yes,
we must accept them.
Yesterday evening at 10 o'clock in bed.
I fall asleep. And your grandson was jumping on your bed.
Yes.
Il nipote stava saltando ancora sul letto. Anyway.
Yes.
Okay, good.
Thank you.
Very well. So, Doris, what about you? Doris, Aurelia.
Allora, ciao Maura, sono Doris.
Ciao Doris.
Posso dire così, premessa.
Okay.
Conversation hour is difficult for me. I am learning English in this year. So... I can above all listen and do short and simple jobs.
Yes.
Fatto questa premessa, ho fatto anch'io il breve sintesi dell'articolo sulla Iaraccio, che ora vado a leggere.
Yes.
When the force of nature meets the love and passion of man, life explodes in a surprising way to reserve us a different future full of surprises. This is demonstrated by the story of this a small plant with yellow flowers, the Milanese Hieracio, because it grows only in Milan and nowhere else in the world. It survived the war. She lived in the walls of the Castello Sforzesco in a few specimens. These, found by the botanist Gabriele Galasso and carried for by him with love, have multiplied. The search for endangered species, their protection and seeding for now is the only way to safeguard plant biodiversity that often survives only in the most unexpected place, in wild or untamed places. Right there, in the disorder, in spite of everything and everyone, nature knows how to give the best of itself. It's up to us to rediscover it and understand its messages. As an old song says, from dung, si dice letame, come flowers.
Ah, yes, of course. So, very well, Doris. It's nice. Anyway, simple, but, well, particular. Okay. I thank you so much.
Thank you.
Go on like this. Sei sulla giusta strada, Doris. Piano piano.
Okay.
Sammy says every day, qualche saggio, qualche piccolo saggio, ma tutti i giorni. Non è importante produrre 200 pagine, ma un piccolo saggio quasi ogni giorno. Questo è l'importante, la costanza. Molto bene. Grazie. I'm very glad. Ok. So, and next I see you. I see here Rossana, Roberta, Santina, Sonia. So, what about you? For example, Rossana, are you there?
Eccomi qua. Non sono riuscita a produrre molto. Avevo iniziato a tradurre l'articolo sul fiore, ma non sono riuscita a finirlo. Per la prossima volta cerco di fare qualcosa di più.
Molto bene. Allora, noi ne approfitto per dire questo, che lunedì ci vediamo ancora alla solita ora, alle 6:30, quindi potete portare ancora qualche altro vostro compito che avete fatto, e poi ci rivediamo il 10 di aprile. Quindi intanto io vi auguro una buona Pasqua a quelli che non vedrò lunedì, e tutti gli altri, niente, ci rivediamo poi o lunedì o il 10 di aprile, questo. Ok, thank you Rossana, stay with us. Let's see Roberta, Santina, Sonia. Sonia? Sonia, are you a new entry, Sonia?
Yes, it's the first time that I joined to the teams, to the group, and I don't know anything about your project or your organization or the course.
Okay, so in this course, like in the previous one, we are going to treat some topics about environment, ecological products, zero waste, everything. And as during April, exactly on the 22nd, we are going to celebrate the Earth Day, la giornata mondiale del pianeta. Mm. And so we are just preparing what we want, especially some topics that we are going to talk about on the 22nd, or better, on the 24th of April, when we come back from holiday. And we do this on Saturday morning at 10 o'clock during conversation, and sometimes even on Monday at 6:30 p.m. during advanced course. So if you want to join us even on the next Monday, you are welcome.
Yes, sir. Okay. And we can choose an article between some article proposed or not.
Yes, well, whatever you do, qualsiasi cosa che riguardi l'ambiente, lo spreco zero, l'ecologia, il bio, le fonti rinnovabili, tutto questo. Oppure, siccome noi abbiamo celebrato anche la giornata mondiale della donna, avevamo scelto ognuno di noi un personaggio noto nel mondo dello spettacolo o dello sport, impegnato in qualche campagna civile, sociale o ambientale. E di questo ne avevamo parlato allora, ma ovviamente, siccome noi manteniamo sempre vivi gli argomenti, non li chiudiamo mai, possiamo parlare anche di quello, anche lunedì stesso. Ok?
So, thank you very much.
Sonia, you are welcome. Stay with us and see you, on Monday. Ok.
Thank you.
Bye. Bene. Bye. Santina, Roberta.
Scusami, prima che legga Santina, volevo dire a Sonia se mi lascia nella chat la sua mail, perché si deve iscrivere al corso come hanno fatto gli altri.
Yes, okay. Certo, e per poterle mandare anche tutte le nostre documentazioni, tutti gli argomenti proposti, ovviamente. Mm-hmm. Molto bene. Okay. Mm-hmm. Grazie mille.
Prego.
Bene.
I am Santina.
Yes.
And I want to tell you that I feel ashamed, but I haven't done anything this week because I was very busy for other things. Anyhow, mm-hmm. I will promise I will go to the Parco delle Cave and mm-hmm. Look for this flower, because I just discovered this park in the last few weeks, and mm-hmm. I find the nature in this park wonderful, because you think you are really in a come dici bosco,
in a wood,
yes, and the nature is not so touched from the human it's yes. Like it should be. It's very, very natural, yes. Mm-hmm. And I found certain atmosphere of peace, and it's really wonderful. Mm-hmm. I was so sorry that I don't live much far away from this park, and I never was there, and it was a nice experience. And this is why this week I worked very, very little with my English, and I went walking in the wood, looking at the nature. And
so let's say you preferred the practice. Hmm?
Yes, but mm-hmm. I have an old right about the Women's Day, but I think it's very, very old and perhaps it's not so interesting. If you want,
well, if you just want to read it, why not?
My personal experience, I just talked about it orally. Do you say orally?
Yes.
But I try to write something. It is my personal experience for the Women's Day. Women's Day takes place every year on the 8th of March to celebrate the achievement of women during these years. I personally don't like much this celebration because much has been done, but a total equity for men and women is still far away. On this day, many happenings are organized, but I enjoy when each person has the possibility to do anything for the women and consequently do it practically. I would like to tell you my experience. I agreed to a charity of women who had breast cancer, and we all lived this experience in the past year. To celebrate the Women's Day, we went to many hospitals in Milan and gave the women the possibility to have a visit gratis. We helped the doctors to organize everything, and I tried to explain to the women the importance of the prevention. This was my way to celebrate Women's Day, a kind of expression of love to the other women, although didn't know them. This year, we don't have this possibility, and my Women's Day is a bit sad, but I still hope for the future. This is
okay, thank you, very interesting. Okay, stay with us, Santina.
All right.
Vediamo un po', non abbiamo sentito Aurelia e Roberta. Aurelia, are you still there?
Yes, but no, I have not write niente perché ho correre dai nipoti. Provvederò a mandarvi qualcosa.
Va bene, ci siamo anche lunedì, prima di Pasqua, poi dopo ci rivediamo il 10, ma lunedì ci siamo. As you like, ok?
Grazie. Aurelia.
Stay with us. And so, let's listen to Roberta, if she wants. Roberta?
Yes, good morning. Sorry, but I have a lot of problems, technical problems. I am using the telephone. I didn't do anything, sorry. I will do it on I'll try to do it for Monday or maybe for the 10th.
Okay, good.
Mm-hmm. I have to write something big or small. Is there a number of rows?
No, just exactly what you want. Okay, never mind, don't worry. Okay, thank Roberta, you. Stay with us.
Thank you.
And what about you, Grazianella? Are you still there?
Yes, for 5 minutes, yes. Allora, electric cars. For me, this is very, very important because I thought that is the first thing that we must organize. In 2015, it was a revolution when the German industry understood that diesel in alternative to petrol was not good to environment. Tightening, indurimento, of the rules has forced the car houses to invest billions to electricity delle loro gamme. The mechanics will change their work. we don't need lubrification grease, cioè grasso lubrificante, engine filters, replacement of oil. Quindi the new car are different that the car that we are habit. Electric cars have less components than petrol cars. They require less manual work. It needs more software. Big modification, so much done in Persian Gulf. Some of the state invest amount of money in solar energy. Aware, quindi consapevoli, that the oil reserves are running out. Quindi they change because there are the sun and they can have another kind of energy. The engineers have begun to develop innovative batteries using lithium, sodium, sulfur. Batteries will create a new industrial sector, consequently new jobs, electrical engineers, electronics and software experts are required. SUVs, le macchine SUVs, have contribute to the change in Europe. Hybrid vehicle registration are 100% higher than in 2020. Pure electric cars have increased by 207. The problem is la presence of recharging power, columns, no? Le colonnine per ricaricare le macchine.
Yes.
The domestic one, other column in the city, in the supermarket, in the car parks. Power columns must be everywhere. We need to product only electric car from 2030. Dal 2030 dovrebbero essere tutte elettriche.
Ok, good.
Sì.
This is It's a great job.
In effect, it is a thing.
Yes.
The most important thing to transform the system.
Ok, I thank you so much, grazie Anella. Io vi ringrazio tutti. I hope, I wish you a very nice Easter, and for those who want, so please join us on Monday. Ok, bye.
Bye.
See you on Monday. Bye. See you next Monday.
Bye.
Ciao.
See you later.